you probably tried to make a paper airplane at some point in your life. And if you're anything like me, it probably flew about 3.5 feet and went straight into the ground. Well, what if you could try again, but, you know, as an adult? Even better, what if you had the decades of knowledge of a diverse team of experts?
My name is Andrew Foote, and I'm president of Paper Outlet here in New York City. I am the paper expert.
My name's Leif, and I am the aerodynamics expert. I am professor of mathematics at NYU, and I study fluid dynamics, mathematics, and physics.
My name's Frankly. I'm the paper folding expert. I work for Tara's Origami Studio in Brooklyn, and I've been doing origami for 22 years.
We're putting our team of bona fide specialists up against three awesome kids.
My name is Jonah Fisher. I'm 10 years old, and when I grow up, I want to be a filmmaker.
My name is Micah. I am 7, and I want to be an astronaut.
My name is Nairobi. I'm 10 years old, and I want to be an archaeologist.
We'll see who can build the best paper airplane. But more than that, we'll learn about the surprisingly wide breadth of expertise that goes into making a seemingly simple piece of folded paper. This is Kids vs. Science.
I've been studying the aerodynamics of paper airplanes recently in order to figure out exactly what makes a paper airplane glide stably.
My first thought when I heard about making paper airplanes was, you know, something I've done many times before. Pretty solid standard origami bit to have, so I'm excited for this.
My understanding would be more grain direction and how it would fold and what stocks would be too heavy. So I'm trying to apply what I know about that to what would make a good paper airplane.
Do you think you'll be the leader of the team? Okay.
Part of me wants to say it will crush the kids, but I've worked with a lot of kids over the years, and some of the stuff they come up with is, you know, is quite amazing.
As adults, we're less creative, we're less open-minded.
It could go either way.
Final thoughts?
No, just, you know, give me some paper.
Each team will be given 1 hour to plan, create, and test their perfect paper airplanes. They will then be judged on distance, hang time, and accuracy. May the best team win.
I sort of think of this as the base state, just a literally a plane made out of paper,
right.
A plane, a flat thing. And then what do we have to do to make it fly?
I hope I am doing this right, though I know for a fact that I'm not.
Why is it like that?
What happens to a plain piece of paper as it, if you drop it in the air, is maybe an interesting thing to compare to a paper airplane.
Yeah.
I give it a little helping start.
Yeah.
That guy.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
I mean, this is a beautiful motion, but it's not what you want from an airplane. Right.
No.
That type of thing.
Look at his YouTube. Whoa, that's gonna be helpful.
It's a lot about balance, right? The most basic thing we all do, right, is we add a little weight in front.
That basic fold there in the front is adding a little bit of weight that's keeping it.
That's the way I was viewing it.
Yeah.
Something that stabilizes it, right? Keeps it
nose
pointed down as it travels through the air. If it goes up, it's going to catch that wind.
By folding it over in front here and not here, you're having a double layer or even more here, right?
Right.
So your balance point still is forward on this thing, right?
Yeah.
We call that the center of mass or center of gravity. I mean, you can't just like cut a triangle out of paper and have it work, right?
No,
yeah, exactly.
The folds are what, it's the, you're getting a triangle shape, but that what you're getting is these folds that are weighting it. I gotcha.
So this is what I've gotten so far.
Wait,
I'm not done yet.
Why is it that?
It's confusing. Okay. Guys, so, I'm not done yet, but I'm really close.
That's where the center of gravity has to be.
Okay.
And if you're like too far in front or too far behind, you don't get a good flight. What about your beautiful flyer? Where is the balance point?
Right about there. It's a little more than 1/3.
Hold it over, then fold it in half.
What do you recommend?
Whatever stock you want.
I like the colored stuff. I know that's not aerodynamically important, but I like the colored stuff.
Pick a color. We got goldenrod, blue, orchid, pink.
Yeah, we were spying on the other team, but don't let them hear you.
You have all these layers on top of each other. They sort of start to spread out a little bit.
Yep.
Up there. So that's what you have to worry about, and that's just the only way to combat it is you're always going to have a little bit of it. But as you fold everything over, make sure that you tuck in as best you can.
I saw that their airplanes are really tiny.
So the weight wouldn't be too much.
I know. I'm in 5th grade.
You're folding all of them over on each other, they'll start to fan out.
Yes.
You can see it here. Even,
yeah, mine
right?
were failures, yeah.
I wouldn't call it a failure. It's just the way paper behaves. Yeah. Right? It's a material, it has thickness to it.
Yeah.
It's gonna behave not in the way, it's not like working with a perfect, like a flat plane or something.
Yeah, but if you use less paper, then they will have to cut down less trees.
But if the paper's already made.
Origami, call this a book fold, is just edge to edge, so bring the long edges together. Use both your hands. Really make sure it's lined up first. And then we call it a kite fold, is when you're basically folding at a 45 degree angle off of this angle bisector. It's never gonna exactly line up. All your folds, if you're getting like 95% there, you're gonna be fine.
Just throw that out, please.
If this is folded unfolded too many times, the thing's just gonna flop open.
Yeah.
You know?
Because those fibers become weaker and weaker and weaker. And
yeah, you're breaking fibers with your finger, you're cracking them. Yeah. There's a certain point, you know, you're not gonna get the plane that you want.
3, 2, 1. My God!
That's good. I think we're all set. Let's go.
Disappoint some kids.
The experts decided to all use one design for their individual airplanes, while the kids each made their own different plane for distance, hang time, and accuracy.
I'm going first. Okay, I'm going first. And I can bend over this, right? A little bit.
Jonah, come on.
Oh!
Whoa! I call interference!
Ready?
Okay. Oh, down.
Ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1.
Good.
Did you see it all the time?
Yeah. Every single time.
Our best strategy we used was YouTube.
Folding tips?
Well, isn't origami all about patience?
Well, yeah, that's part of it, right? It's really taking your time. Don't rush whatever you're doing. Whenever you're working with paper, always
take
your
time. This is my advice. Have someone guarding the door at all times.
Actually, I think you have the right instinct here. This is a good, basic 70-pound
Wait, 70 pounds?
Out of the first folds, I'm making sure everything's lined up first. I'm holding it down.
So what's the next step?
Good job. Make sure you crease it all the way out, especially to the tip. Too.
Micah, you ready?
Hey guys, I'm Justin. I had so much fun producing this video, the first in a new series. If you liked it too and you want to see more episodes just like this, make sure to comment below. And if you have any ideas for any fun activities we can have kids and experts go head to head on, make sure to throw those in the comments too. Like and subscribe to stay up to date with all things Mental Floss. Thanks for watching.